Folks, today we're going to be doing antimicrobial susceptibility testing and also sometimes it's referred to as antibiotic sensitivity testing. It's all the same. The process is the same, right? So what we're going to do is if we think about just a big outfit, like a big hospital, they're going to have all this stuff that's going to be automatic, right? They have these big instruments that they can put the organisms in. They put it in a cart. The cart goes into this incubator. The incubator is read by a computer, and then the computer spits out a probability of the organism being sensitive or resistant based on what's going on, right? Smaller outfits don't have that, so I'm going to teach you the clinical way to do what we call a Kirby Bauer. Kirby Bauer, the two scientists who actually came up with the process. It's very easy to do, and it's a lot of fun. Now, here at Riverside, we don't have a lot of the beautiful amenities that some of the other campuses have, so we have to do it old school, okay? So the first thing we want to do is we want to prepare what we call confluent growth. Sometimes confluent growth is known as a lawn of growth. And so what that means is we want to put a population of organisms on the surface of the plate so that we can challenge the antimicrobial agents. And today we can either do antibiotics, there's disinfectants back there, there might even be some essential oils that you can test, right? And so you can select any of these things to do. I'm gonna show you the process and then you're gonna decide how to do it, right? So here is just a plate. Now typically we use this stuff called Mueller-Hinton. We don't really have to do it because this is a teaching lab. So we're just gonna use TSA today. It works just fine, right? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to streak it in a manner that I'm going to provide this lawn of organisms that are going to grow over the entire plate. And the way I do that is I'm going to streak it at 0 degrees, at 90 degrees, and then at 120, okay? And I'm going to use a different type of method than we normally streak plates for isolation, which we use a loop. Here I'm going to use a cotton applicator stick. And in order to make sure that I have the proper population, Myra has already made for us some McFarlands of these organisms. Remember, when we think about how much organism we're putting into a plate, it's about turbidity, right? Turbidity is really the concentration of organisms, right? The more turbid, the more concentration we have. Usually when we get organisms at our desk on a daily basis, we have about a concentration of what we would call a 6 or 7 McFarland, right? This is what a half or 0.5 McFarland looks like, right? It's not very strong at all. And that's the population we want. We want either a 0.5 or a 1 McFarland, and that's what I have here, okay? So I'm just gonna select Staphylococcus aureus, and I'm going to make a lawn on this plate, okay? So the way I do that is I'm just simply going to open up the cotton applicator stick. And as long as I do not touch the applicator, the cotton swab is sterile, okay? I'm gonna come in here and I'm going to get the organism on my cotton swab. I'm just gonna mix it up in there, what we call getting the applicator stick wetted, and that's typically what we say, it just gets wetted. And so I've got the organism on here, but now I'm wringing out the organism on the surface here of the tube so that I don't get a lot of excess moisture, because when I start to streak, I don't want to get all this moisture going everywhere. Okay, I am now ready to make the confluent growth or the lawn on this plate. And so what I like to do is take this and I like to draw one line down the middle. And what that does is that transfers any excess moisture I might have on the cotton applicator stick to the media. Therefore, when I start streaking, it doesn't fly, okay? Now I'm ready, this is 0 degrees. I'm gonna take that applicator and I'm just going to very tightly and very softly streak the entire surface of that plate. You'll notice I'm coming down a little bit so that I can streak it perfectly, okay? So I've got streaked this way. I'm gonna move it 90 degrees now, right? And now I'm going to do it another time. All the way across so that you can see how I'm getting all the surface of the plate. Then I'll move it an additional 30 and I'm doing it one last time. So now what I hope I've done is I've created a lawn of growth or confluent growth. I like to go around the edges in case there's any excess moisture. I pick it up and then this just goes into the biohazard container. this is ready to be used as a basis for testing the efficacy of antibiotics. Okay? Now, some places that have a lot more money than Riverside have these little impingers that you can just push down and it plunges and it puts 12 different antibiotics on here. We're not going to do it that way. We're going to do it the old school way. You need some alcohol and you need a pair of tweezers, right? So put the pair of tweezers here, put it in the alcohol, let the flame go out. And then what you want to do is you want to select an antibiotic. And this is one of my favorites. This is nitrofurantoin, right? Also known as macrodantin. It's really good for urinary tract. So I'm just going to go ahead and use it. I'm going to pull the antibiotic out just like this. And then I'm going to place it on the plate at some place. And I'm going to put about 4 or 5 of these antibiotics on there. The antibiotics have a little bit of some embossed or printed letters on it that indicate what they are, right? If you're going to do any of the things that we've made in-house, the disinfectants, antiseptics, or any of the essential oils, they're not going to be that. So you're going to have to mark that on the bottom of the plate, okay? This is potentially contaminated with the antibiotic. I'm going to put it in here. I'm going to go ahead and flame it so that it might remove any of the excess residue. And then I'm going to select a different antibiotic. And so the one that I've selected here, I don't really like. It's bacitracin. That's for something different. This one is, oh boy. Oh, this is levofloxacin. I like this one a lot. This is Levaquin. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it out just a little bit. So I have Levaquin here, and I'm gonna place it on here so that it's as equidistant as I am from the other one, right? When I put it down, I just press on it gently to make sure that it sticks, adheres to the actual media. And then I'm gonna put this in here, flame it, and grab another antibiotic. So this is a beautiful antibiotic. This is tacrosolin cladionic acid. And if, I'm gonna take it, I'm gonna pull it out of there and put it on here equidistant from the others, right? Just like this. Okay. Put it in here, flame, and then I'm gonna select another one. And the one I selected is naldexic acid. That's good enough, I'll do that, I like it. Fizzle. And I'm going to put this on here, equidistant from each other. Now I could put more, but I think that's plenty, right? That's all I need, because this is a teaching lab. We're just learning about how this stuff works, right? I'm going to flame this one last time. And remember, safety first, never place hot tweezers into the alcohol, okay? So I'm really done with the flame. I'm going to go ahead and turn that off, but we're going to talk a little bit more about what's going to happen here. The discs contain a concentration of the antibiotic. The concentration in the on that disc is going to diffuse out into the media radially, right? So it's going to go in all directions. Where it comes in contact with an organism that is susceptible to it, it's going to kill it, right? And so if you look over at the board here, you can see that up at the very top, I've drawn this to represent a disc, and then growth is represented by the black concentrated lines. And then that area that there's a blue line is called really the zone of inhibition, right? And so we're measuring that zone of inhibition, right? And we're gonna get a number in millimeters, and we're gonna compare that number in millimeters to a standard to know whether or not that particular antibiotic is going to be effective at killing an organism, whether it be, I don't know, an Enterobacteriaceae or whatever we're doing, right? We're gonna be able to look and see how it might be effective against that. The one closest to the next board, you can see, has got the disc, but then it's got the growth happening right up to the disc, right? So the organism is growing right up to the disc. That means that when the antibiotic diffused out into the media, it didn't have an effect on the organism. Therefore, the organism grew right up to it, right? And what we say there is that particular organism is resistant to whatever the antimicrobial agent is that is on the disc, okay? So if we get that kind of a result so that the organism is growing right up to the disc, that's an automatic resistant. The issue comes to evaluate when there is a zone, we want to make sure that we measure that zone and compare it to a standard, because if it meets or is beats that particular standard, then we know that that particular antibiotic or whatever it is going to be effective. If it doesn't fall within the range, even though there's a zone, it's not going to work. And so therefore, we're not going to use that antibiotic for a patient who has that particular infectious agent in their body. Okay? Any questions? Thank you, Trent.